about something that was similar to this. And one of the problems they were having with this, Chad, was the accumulation of hydrates. How are they avoiding that problem this time? Do you know?
Completely different system. The open system that we had before was this almost rocket ship-like cap that went over the top that wasn't very efficient. It was a dynamic seal, which means it wasn't really a seal, and oil would come around it and go up and away from it. That's kind of what it looked like. The hydrate problem really came in with the older one, which was much larger, and hydrates can be thought of as almost like ice crystals, although it's just a little bit different. How does it get cold at the surface of the ocean down there when this is obviously water? Well, you have to understand that there's pressure down below the ocean. That pressure is allowed to expand as soon as it gets out one of these holes, either the hole in the bottom of the ocean, the hole at the top of the blowout preventer, or the hole somewhere else. And as it expands, it cools off, like trying to cool off your coffee by going like this. You purse your lips. You make a small hole, then all of a sudden the air goes away. As it expands, the air cools off. If you try to cool off your coffee like this, it doesn't really work because it's not pursing your lips and it's not really all that cold. Your air is still 98.6 degrees coming out. So as this air expanded, which was the gas, the methane, all those gases that were part of this crude mixture, and we know that there's an awful lot more in there than just crude oil. It expanded, it got cold, it filled this up with things that clogged it. So now what they've done is they took this pipe with warm, I want to say almost water, but it's not. It's a complete mixture of almost like an antifreeze and a methanol, and that came down there and it kept this part, the inner part, warm enough that these hydrates never did work, never did form. But now they're getting rid of this all together. So Sean, take it away. And then this little part there, that part that was bent over, that kink that they cut off, it was an ugly cut, it was crooked because it was damaged. And they couldn't get a good seal on top with that part that we just took off. They got rid of that. They took that away yesterday, and they bolted on a brand new, nicely sealable cap top to this thing. The top now looks good. It's got a nice ring on it. They're going to bring another part down. You called it the blower preventer. It's just another cap. Yeah. As it comes down, it's going to clamp itself on there. Going to be a good seal here, and then make a good seal here, and the whole thing is stopped.
So that last part you just showed us right there, the top part, that's not there yet?
Yeah, it's there. It's there.
Oh, it's there. Is.
And oil's still coming out already. Oil's still coming out of the
so
top
let's,
here.
Let's get a live picture if we possibly can. Do we have a live shot? Okay, that, there it is, Chad.
That's the top of the top. The top of the new. That is not the top of the old. That's the part that they put on their 150,000-pound part that drops from the ocean all the way down to the bottom. So oil is still coming out. Yes, we know that. And then they're going to start to close these valves. As the closed valves start to get closed, the whole thing is going to begin to get pressurized. That's where it gets interesting. Did the old blow-up preventer, was it damaged enough that when these valves shut, will the blow-up preventer literally explode? Will it be able to take 8,000 PSI or not?
8,000 PSI. Professor, you've been listening to this explanation. We're all crossing our fingers and hoping that this thing works. Now, you give us a dosage of reality, if you possibly
can. Yes, please.
What is the possibility that it won't work, and if so, why not?
Well, there's a really high probability that it will work, and the reason being is that it is a good sealing cap. And they have valves that they can control. They can open and close them as much as they need to. And basically what they're going to do in the test is try to close the system completely down and do a pressure test where they set it for a period of time and allow the pressure to build up. And as that pressure builds up, if it gets up around 8,000 to 9,000 PSI, then they'll have a good indication that the well has good integrity and that all the seals are going to hold.
Professor, let me just stop you real quick. Sure. Rather than looking at the professor, who's, by the way, a very handsome man, why don't we look at the shot of this thing underground, under the water, so we can see it. No, not that one. The one where you actually see the oil leaking, guys. Switch over to the other shot. Thank you very much. Professor, as we're looking at this, we're wondering, and you said, well, they're going to do this, and they're going to do that, and then they're going to seal this up and close it up. Why is it taking so long? I mean, if they have the apparatus in place, why not go ahead and do it, like, right away?
Well, if you seal it immediately, it'll be like a shock to the system, and it'll be like a train running into a brick wall. And what they want to do is slow this train down, so to speak, slowly with a set of brakes, and that's what they're going to do. And the first thing they're doing right now is they're actually closing down all the production ports that were sucking oil out of the oil stream. They're going to close that down so that they have a complete seal at that point. Then they're going to close the chokes in this new apparatus down slowly so that they can slowly break that flow. And the reason they're doing that is they want to make sure they don't damage anything. There is a high probability that there could be some damage, and it's also possible there's limited damage and it won't be a problem. But they need to turn off the flow slowly so they don't shock the system, because a powerful shock like this could damage even a well-designed,
so you want to,
well-planned.
Yeah, well, anytime you're dealing with something that involves, what'd you say, Chad, 8,000 PSI?
Well, yeah, even at 60 PSI, you shut your faucet off too much on your kitchen faucet, you can jerk your whole water system.
Right.
Multiply that by a couple hundred.
So you want to go real slow and you want to go carefully. All right, best case scenario, Professor, when do you believe, for our viewers who want to know, that we will look at this picture and finally not see all that oil gushing up? Best case scenario, in the next couple of hours, 3, 4, by tomorrow morning, what?
The best case scenario, in the next couple of hours, you'll start to see it slow down, and they'll start to secure and close all the valves. And if the pressure maintains itself, they'll hold it steady for 2 days. But of course, while they have it steady, there will be no oil coming out of it, unless there is a leak somewhere. One of the issues they're trying to do is look at some seismic so they can take a look at the subsurface and make sure there's no leaks in the subsurface.
We'll be checking, and we'll be checking back with you, Chad.